Hello, squids, kids, and cephalopods of all kinds. Make sure you don't have ink in your ears because it's time to listen up. I'm Shroom, scientist of all things Woomy, and today I'm joined by Kid, the captain of Team Spark. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi everyone, my name is Kid. I am head captain of Team Spark USA. Gotta specify which Team Spark since there's more than one of us now. But yeah, we're in the North American region. I'm glad to be here today.
Fun fact, I don't know if Shroomy's already mentioned, but Shroomy was originally on Team Spark, like, how many months ago? Like, 3 months ago? Maybe four? I've lost track of time now. But yeah, we played Splatoon together and it was great. And we're still playing Splatoon, separate, unfortunately, but together whenever we can during Splatfest or whenever we need people.
So, did you ever play Splatoon 1 competitively?
I did for a little bit. So, fun fact, back around, like, the launch of Splatoon 1, I, too, was, like, a little octoling that didn't know, or a little squid that didn't know anything about this game. I kept up with, like, the announcement for it at E3 back in 2015. And when I first picked up the game, I was like, this is fun. This could be something really competitive, or this could be something getting to that esports side of things. But I didn't know how to get there or what I had to do to be there. So I found like this like Facebook group that was all about Splatoon, and I just hopped on board. I was like, hey, I play this game. What do I gotta do to play competitive? And there was like these groups of people that I met along the way that made this one team. I think it was called Bolts or something like that, if I remember correctly. And we played a couple of small games, nothing big. But we had a lot of fun competitively, and it kind of sparked my interest to create Spark towards the end of Splatoon 1 era.
So do you have any advice for new competitive players? As in,
best advice I have is just, if you're interested in it, definitely go all out for it. Whether you're like the best of the best or the worst of the bunch, as long as you're having fun, that's all that matters. Because once the game is no longer fun, then you're just kind of burning yourself out. So this is a good game. Enjoy all the wins, enjoy all the loss. Because at the end of the day, it is just a game. So just enjoy it for as long as you possibly can.
So have you played in a Lootie tournament?
I played a couple. One was for like a sub. One was for our current team, Spark. We did our first official season with revamped Spark 2.0, and it was a great time. My team, I have 5 pseudo branches within our team. One that I specifically oversee is called Atrovirans, and we had a blast. Obviously, we did not make it to the semifinals or the finals, unfortunately. We were very close. We were very, very close, but unfortunately we didn't make it. But during those little matches we had some ups, we had some downs, and the best one I can remember was one of our mates, 8-Ball and Pineapple, they were screaming, they were shouting to get like the last point for Clam Blitz or the last few seconds of Rainmaker, and it was just a great time.
So, why do you like being a captain?
Enjoy eating sweets, if that makes sense. Versus, I enjoy being a captain because I can inspire other people to be better at the game, or even just being better as a person as well. I've always been told that I was a very positive motivator in people's lives, and I kind of took that inspiration to be, well, what can I do with this social skill that I have to help those that don't have that kind of social skill? So being head captain, it kind of helps me help you, help everybody else to get to where they want to be, whether it's with me in the Team Spark or being a different team somewhere else. Like, I've had people come back to me and tell me, hey, this was the best team I've ever been on, or this is the best first team I've signed up for. I'm like, I'm glad that's what we did for you. So being captain, just getting that, like, feedback, or just getting, like,
I definitely enjoyed being on your team as the first team. It really helped me open up to talking to people.
That's what I've been told. It's like, I don't know what it is. People tend to have like this weird, like, magnetic thing where I can attract people into like a good, comforting inner circle to where people can like express themselves. I've met so many, like, even if it's not in this game, I've met so many other people that would tell me like, hey, I've never really been so open with anyone in my life except with you. I'm like, I'm glad I can be like your safe space. I'm glad you can come to me to do these kinds of topics and certain things. I mean, having mates in our team that are part of the LGBTQ plus group, or be a part of like, hey, I've experienced the same trauma as you did, it kind of helps me help them, help everyone else around them to be more comforting, more open, or even to just learn how to be better. That's what I'm here for, just to help you get there.
Was playing competitive.
There you go, but it's kind of nice to hear that people come back to me that they actually respect all the work that I've done for them, even if it turns out we went our separate ways. It's very nice to hear.
Was playing competitive in Splatoon 1 a lot different than it is now?
Oh, definitely, for sure. Because Ludi didn't officially come around until, like, I think it was officially in Splatoon 2, but Splatoon 1 League was more like, hey, I know someone that plays Splatoon, do you want to play with us? I'm like, sure, absolutely. It was definitely a little bit smaller in Splatoon 1. It wasn't as, like, big as it is in Splatoon 2, and even more massive as it is in Splatoon 3.
So, what made you want to be competitive?
I would say I'm a very competitive person, for sure. I wouldn't say that I'm like hardcore competitive driven, but I'm definitely for the passion of the game. In Splatoon 2, when I formed Spark, we were a little bit smaller, and I thought, hey, this would be a good opportunity to get competitive, or at least to find people with the same mindset. But closer towards the end of the Splatoon 2 lifespan, it kind of like shifted the vision of Spark from being this competitive team to be more of a like, hey, this is a, I wouldn't say, it's definitely a family feel team now, but it was at the end of it more of like, hey, I have people I can bond with, I can play with. So there's definitely going to be waves for Spark and for myself where it's going to be, hey, I want to be super competitive, or hey, I need to take a chill pill, hey, I want to go back to competitive. I've always been about like mental health, don't overstride yourself, don't like push yourself to do, you know, what you want to do. You have to take time to pull back a little bit, relax, look back to what you did good, what you did wrong, and then go back even stronger the next time. So competitive, yes, 100% for it. But I also have to, you know, be more mindful of myself to like, hey, you're pushing yourself too much where it's no longer feeling fun. Let's take 3 steps back a little bit, analyze what you've done, what you've accomplished, and see what more you can do for yourself, and then come right back in when you're ready to strive even harder.